vegetables. A wide assortment of fresh fish. And look, all kinds of food you can eat on the spot. From food to clothing to daily necessities, you can find anything you need in the dense cluster of shops in a Japanese shopping street. A typical Japanese shopping street is one long road lined with buildings that serve as both shops and homes. There are 13,000 shopping streets across Japan. For a long time, they have been the heart of neighborhood life. But in recent years, shopping streets have been in decline. And this decline has prompted various efforts to revive them. On this edition of Begin Japanology, our theme is shopping streets. We'll explore their history, their role in Japanese life, and the story of those working to ensure they have a future.
Hello and welcome to Begin Japanology. I'm Peter Barakan. In English, we talk about arcades and markets and malls. The Japanese shopping street has elements of all of those, but it's a little bit different, as we'll see on today's program. I've come to Togoshi Ginza, which is the longest shopping street in Tokyo, and something like 400 shops. In England, we have high streets, and when we think of those, we have an image of a major road with considerable traffic flow. Although the Japanese shopping street tends to be set back from the main road. Also, another thing that's unique to Japanese shopping streets is that you have produce lined up in front of the shop so that passers-by can pick things up in their hands. Now, if they started doing that in Europe, we all know what would happen. Let's take a look at just what a Japanese shopping street is.
A shopping street is, of course, a street with shops on either side. But the Japanese government has an official definition. There must be at least 30 shops together along the road. Shops are lined up along a single thoroughfare, and in many cases, the shops double as homes. While each shop is managed independently, a shopping street usually has an association, and all the shopkeepers are members. The shops are not arranged in any special order. A greengrocer may be next to a general store, a butcher's next to a clothing store, each benefiting from the customer traffic that the other shops generate. The stores exist together and prosper together. Shopping street associations run various activities that aim to attract more customers. They might decide to cover the street with a roof, or redesign the lampposts and pavements, or make other improvements to boost the street's overall image. The roof protects shoppers from the elements, so people keep coming even in rain or snow. It also protects the products displayed outside a shop from strong sunlight. Associations don't just manage the upkeep of facilities, they also organize events. Member shops will run sales at the same time and hold lotteries with big prizes. They do what they can to make the shopping street an exciting place to visit. Like department stores, shopping streets are home to a diverse mixture of shops, and they are always trying very hard to attract more shoppers. Now, what aspects of shopping streets do shoppers particularly enjoy? There are all kinds of shops and things are inexpensive. I like that I can communicate with the salespeople at these shops. It makes shopping fun. Let's take our own shopping trip. This is Sunamachi Ginza, a shopping street in an old neighborhood of Tokyo. This old-fashioned shopping street runs for 670 meters in a straight line. It has 180 shops.
Hello.
The shopping street is crowded all day long with an average of 15,000 shoppers. People are drawn to fresh ingredients and low prices. For example, one cabbage here is just 80 yen. And a daikon radish is 100 yen. That's 20 or 30% less than the price at a supermarket. Now on to this fishmongers, where as many of these fresh fish as you can stuff in a bag cost just 300 yen. 5 to 10 fish will fit in a bag, which means that each one costs only 30 to 60 yen. But shopping streets have more to offer than just raw ingredients. You'll also find lots of delicious ready-to-eat dishes. Here's a shop selling grilled chicken on a stick. There are more than 10 different kinds of chicken skewers, and they're all 100 yen each. Here's a tempura shop. Seafood, including shrimp, squid, whiting and horse mackerel, vegetables like peppers, pumpkin and aubergine, all fresh from the fryer and priced from 70 to 150 yen each. When the weather gets cold, nothing beats oden. Oden is a kind of hot pot that includes daikon radish, kelp, tofu, boiled eggs, and various dumplings made from minced fish, all simmered in a soy sauce-based broth. You buy just the bits you want, at prices ranging from 50 to 100 yen. At this shop, most of the food is 200 yen per 100 grams. Boiled pumpkin. Butterbur and bamboo shoots. And a huge variety of homemade pickles. All the classic flavors of Japan. And if you buy these 8 items, you can get the whole selection for just 1,500 yen. This is what shopping streets are all about. The fun of seeking out items at reasonable prices.
These days, people overwhelmingly do their shopping in supermarkets, but if you like the personal touch, this is the sort of place to come to. Let's try one of these shops. This is a butcher's shop, and in the back here, they've got a case with some pre-cooked food. There's pork cutlets in here and various types of croquettes. Now, in Europe, croquettes are things you tend to eat in French restaurants, but for example, here they have, it's like mashed potato with breadcrumbs and it's been deep fried. It's a cheap and nourishing and very tasty food, actually.
Would you like to try one of these?
Yes, please.
This is our most popular type of croquette.
Oh, this is a very typical thing that a lot of butcher's shops will do for you.
It's just been fried and it's very hot.
Thank you. Arigatou gozaimasu. But it's quite warm. Mmm. Mmm. Ooh. Hot. Mm. You can probably hear how crispy it is, straight out of the fryer. That is really good. I might take home a whole bag full of those for dinner, actually. Excellent stuff. What's nice about doing business here in an environment like this, rather than being in a supermarket, for example?
The Togoshi district has an old-time feel and a great sense of warmth, and the people here are very friendly. There are many customers who come into the shop wanting to chat.
Thank you very much. Well, we've looked at what shopping streets look like now. Let's go back now and take a look at the history of how they started and how they developed.
In Japan, shopping streets first appeared in the 16th century. Japan was then in a period of civil war. Local lords built castles, and towns sprang up around them. To promote commerce and community growth, a new policy mandated free markets and open guilds. Previously, merchants had belonged to guilds organized by trade, These guilds monopolize raw materials and the manufacture and sale of goods. But under the new policy, the monopolies were broken, and new merchants were able to sell items freely. In castle towns, rows of shops began to appear, and the shopping street was born. In the 17th century, shopping streets took another step forward. The long years of turmoil had come to an end. An age of peace had dawned, and people were travelling. Shopping streets now sprang up away from the castle towns. They appeared along highways, on the approaches to shrines and temples, in port towns, and wherever else plenty of people were coming and going. In Edo, as Tokyo was then called, a shopping area formed around Nihonbashi, a bridge in the city center. Shopping streets bustled with eager shoppers. From the mid-19th century to the 20th century, the population of Japan grew quickly. A nationwide rail network was built, and all kinds of goods became available around the country. Shopping streets were more vibrant than ever. Then came the Second World War. Many of Japan's shopping streets were burned to the ground in air raids. After the war ended, people started selling things out on the street itself. Goods were scarce, but black markets conjured supplies seemingly out of thin air. These markets kept people going. Vendors drew shoppers, and shoppers drew vendors. Shopping streets slowly came back to life. Still shaken by defeat, the people of Japan began the long journey to recovery by shopping on the nation's high streets. Later, in Japan's economic boom years, shopping streets reached a peak of activity. The whole family would enjoy a day out in city center shopping streets. Japan's shopping streets have always thrived by providing what people need in everyday life.
And this is the original Ginza, perhaps the best known shopping street in the whole of Tokyo, lined with department stores and luxury boutiques. Interestingly, the name Ginza is used in over 300 different shopping streets all over Japan. In many cases, the aspiration behind using the name Ginza was to acquire some of the commercial success and perhaps a little of the luxury brand image as well. However, some shopping streets, particularly in smaller provincial towns, have experienced steep declines in recent years. There are a number of reasons for this. One is that people just have such divergent lifestyles these days. Another is that more and more people depend on their cars to get around, and this leads to the existence of big shopping malls with enormous car parks. There are many shopping streets across Japan that have just died out completely. You'll see shop after shop where the shutters have just been pulled down and are left down, and whole streets become known as shutter streets. Let's take a look now at some people's efforts to try to revive shopping streets.
This is the city of Takamatsu in Shikoku, Japan's smallest main island. One of the most crowded places in the city is the Marugame Machi shopping street, which has a history of over 400 years. It runs for 470 meters and has 160 shops. At its height, the street had annual sales of 27 billion yen. But in the late 1980s, a bridge was built linking Shikoku with Japan's largest main island, Honshu. And that enabled big supermarket chains to do business on the outskirts of Takamatsu. Marugame Machi began losing customers to these powerful rivals. Ultimately, it became a shutter street. The shopkeepers tried to figure out how to revive their shopping street. We did things to suit ourselves. We failed to grasp what ordinary customers really wanted. That was the biggest factor in our failure. They sent a fact-finding team around Japan and even to Europe. And they concluded that the problem lay with the traditional organization of their shopping street. Like most shopping streets, Marugame Machi had many independent landowners. They operated their own shops and recruited their own tenants. As a result, there were too many shops of a certain type, and there wasn't enough fresh blood. The shopping street had fallen out of step with the times and lost its appeal. So Marugame Machi started a neighborhood management company. The company was launched by all the members of the Streets Association. Its mission was to build a plaza-type space and create a new kind of shopping experience. The first step was to separate land ownership from land use. The neighborhood management company leased land from the shopkeepers and built on that. They recruited tenants from all over Japan with a track record of success. Shops that had fallen behind the times were replaced. Also, the company tried to find the right balance of shops and the best place to put them. The shopping street was rebuilt from scratch. The nice assortment of attractive new shops brought in three times more money than in the period before redevelopment. And the new street drew 50% more people. The management company also built a hospital and flats in the shopping street. People visiting the hospital and living in the flats also add to the number of shoppers. So the street is becoming more and more lively. The city of Hirakata in suburban Osaka takes another approach. Here an event was held to draw more young people to the shopping street. The event was planned by members of the Merchant Association. The venue was the shopping street's pubs. The event was a drinking party where men and women could mingle and meet. Usually matchmaking parties like this are for around 5 or 6 men and women. But this event drew around 200 of each sex. I thought, why not? Let's see what happens. The entry fee was 6,000 yen. That included 2 hours of all-you-can-drink fun at any of the street's pubs. At each venue, local merchants were around to help break the ice. You two? You'd make a good couple. The event wasn't just limited to the pubs. Participants also received discount coupons that they could use at the street shops. New couples could have a commemorative photo taken. Even discount rings were being sold. Those who didn't find a boyfriend or girlfriend could visit the beauty parlor to get a new look and try again. It would be great if couples kept coming back to the pub where they first met. We'd love that. If people who meet at these parties start marrying and living in the neighborhood, then obviously everyday business in the shopping street will perk up. The matchmaking party concept is drawing a lot of interest in other ailing Japanese shopping streets.
Those kind of large-scale matchmaking parties that we've just seen might seem a little strange, but apparently these days they're spreading to other shopping streets around Japan. It's an indication, perhaps, of how hard it can be for young people these days to find partners. And of course, they benefit both the organizers and the customers. It's not easy to try to revive a shopping street that's in decline. But even in some of these so-called shutter streets, there are still people soldiering on. Let's take a look at some of them.
the city of Kita Kyushu in Fukuoka Prefecture. This is the port of Moji, which faces the Kanmon Strait. Not far from the harbour is a shopping street that has a special place in local hearts, Moji's Central Market. It sprang up soon after the Second World War, originally as a black market. Years ago, it was a thriving district with all kinds of shops. But as the local population shrank, the street went into decline. Once there were 72 shops. Eventually, more than half ended up shuttered. But the survivors include some unique places. This shop sells rice, but competition from supermarkets took away much of that trade. So the owner makes and sells box lunches and ready-to-eat foods. Each item makes a tiny profit. The shop owner is Itsuko Haba. Her motto is short on profit, long in business. What makes me happiest is when a customer tells me they like the food. She doesn't go after short-term gains. I'm sorry. Thank you for your phone call, but I can't help you today. Please call again. I'm so sorry. An urgent order comes in for 12 box lunches, but Haba turns it down. If I used frozen ingredients, I could prepare meals right away. But I don't like the idea. I would lose the trust that I've built up. One customer comes over every day, and she's not even shopping for anything. Her name is Shigeko Sakaki. She waits for Haba to arrive each morning and helps her to open the shop. I just help out. She lets me help here. I live alone, and I feel lonely at home. I'd feel depressed if I didn't come here. It helps me to keep my spirits up. At first, Sakaki just came to buy food, but she gradually found herself spending more and more time in the shop. Now she looks after the shop while Haba makes deliveries. These days, the place is more than just a shop. It brings together people who live alone. The shutter street. The sound of a sewing machine. This tailor has been in business for more than 60 years. The shop's owners, Sumiko Toki and her cousin, Yoshiko Otsuka, run the place themselves. Good morning. I have a rush job. Their main work is doing alterations, such as taking in hems and waists. But they boast that they can handle any tailoring job. The problem is, they don't always finish the work on time. Could you wait until 10? Have you done your shopping? No? Come by afterwards then. They tend to fall behind because they insist on doing everything to perfection. Today's order is remaking a kimono into a jacket. To transform a Japanese garment into a Western one is a difficult task, demanding skill and a certain artistic sense. The customer looks happy with the results. This place is amazing. They never get things done by the time they tell their customers they will. But still, I keep coming back no matter how slow they are. And all their customers feel the same way. These relationships of trust have been built over decades. Today, a new cafe is opening opposite Haber's shop. For years, businesses have been closing down. But now a young person is setting up shop. Haber has had decades of experience, and the new shopkeeper is getting the full benefit of her wisdom. There is more good news. A customer who often buys Haber's dishes has placed an order for rice. $10 kilograms of rice for 5,250 yen. That's about as much as Haber usually makes in a day. A long-term relationship with a customer has borne fruit. I'll work until I die. I want to live a long time and keep working as long as my body's in good shape. In this venerable shopping street in Kita Kyushu's Moji district, community bonds are strong. And a few determined merchants are battling on with smiles and laughter.
Times change and old communities break down, but that new cafe might just be a sign of a new community emerging. One certainly hopes so. Social interaction has been on the wane in Japan's cities for a long time now, and these shopping streets are as much about a sense of community as they are about just buying and selling things. We actually don't have anything like this in my neighborhood, but it's quite fun to come to a shopping street like this once in a while just to get a taste of that community, which is something all too rare in Tokyo these days. If you're planning a visit to Japan, I would certainly recommend you come and get a taste of it for yourself. I'll see you again next time.
Next time, we'll meet bird fanciers who value roosters for their appearance and the way they crow, and also experts who can tell the sex of a chick at a glance. And we'll see an impressive range of egg dishes.